There's a calm surrender to the rush of day. When the heat of a rolling wave can be turned away.
An enchanted moment, and it sees me through. It's enough for this restless warrior just to be with you.
It is where we are. It's enough for this wide-eyed wanderer that we've got this far. And can you feel the love tonight? How it's led believe the very best.
There's a time for everyone if they only learn that the twisting kaleidoscope moves us all in turn.
There's a rhyme and reason to the wild outdoors. When the heart of the star-crossed Voyager beats in time with yours.
And can you feel the love tonight?
Tonight.
It is where we are. It's enough for this one.
It's enough to make kings there.
ada poda jadi smoothies.
You know, I don't put it in the oven. I think.
Appreciate you and say thank you for this day and beautiful day you have given us. As we all declare together that this is the day the Lord has made for us to be happy and pleased in it. Our Heavenly Father, we have received this day as a gift from you. A day which has never been there since the world was formed. A day that you knew, my Father, my God, that Jerry and Jeremy will go and make their home. My Father, my God, want to appreciate you and say thank you. Even as we appreciate you for Jerry's parents, for the work they have done this far, my Father, my God, to bring Jerry to this far, my Father. May you who have stood with her up to this time, the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we cannot take anything for granted. We also want to thank you, my Father, my God, for Jeremy's parents, that the work they have done to bring Jeremy this far. My Father, my God, we want to thank you because about marriage, it was ordained of you in the Garden of Eden. My Father, my God. Therefore,
Yesu apewe utukufu, tangaza upendo wake.
Oh, we give all the glory to Jesus and tell of his love, and tell of his love.
God. Therefore, we are only doing what you have commanded us to do. And therefore, we are so humbled this morning as relatives, as sisters and brothers, as friends, my Father, my God, to come and celebrate with Juliet and Jeremy for what you are doing, my Father, my God. When Jerry was born, my Father, my God, there was a jubilation that a baby girl was born. Today, my Father, my God, we are here to say thank you for this one you have brought her. And Lord, we continue to prophesy and make decree that she is going to live, my Father, my God, to her full time, my Father, my God, on this earth, to declare the works of God in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We want to declare, my Father, my God, as Jerry leaves this home, my Father, my God, to the place that you have destined for her, my Father, the mighty name of Jesus, we come against every powers of darkness. In the mighty name of Jesus, which can go, my Father, my God, and they are destroying homes. And we are declaring, as far as Jerry is concerned, her home is going, my Father, my God, to be intact. All the way in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we appreciate you. For this, my Father, my God, you are doing today. We thank you for her family, my Father, my God. We thank you for the fruit of her womb. And we declare they are all blessed. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God, we are so humble. There are many families waiting to see this happening in their homes. My Father, my God. And there today we can say thank you that because you have favored us. That today we are celebrating one of our girls getting married, my Father. We thank you and we worship you. We give you the honor, we give you the glory. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray and we believe.
Amen.
Na Yesu apewe utukufu.
Tangaza upendo.
Together we have the honor, literally the front row seats to Jeremy's action. Thank you, Jeremy, for that honor. We want to start straight away. I have seen the bride with my own eyes. Jeremy was telling me, just start. I am not required to ever start a wedding until I see the bride myself. I could bring you a Rachel or a Leah, you know? No, I'm not required to do that. I know you've been excited. Please, Jeremy, stand up. He bribed me enough not to keep him long, and I won't keep him long. How about you stand up and you face the people? Best man, when Jeremy stands up, you stand up. If he runs away, you run after him and bring him here. Otherwise, you and I are going to have a very long day entertaining all these guests. All right. Our Heavenly Father, you are the author and the one who came up with the idea of marriage. Father, right now, I know for sure that heaven is rejoicing because of what is just about to happen here. Father, I thank you because this journey you started between Jeremy and Juliet when none of us was there, and yet you've allowed us to be part of this and indeed be here, healthy and excited of their union. So Father, we invite your presence to be with us even as we start and until the end. And all this we ask, believing and trusting in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
In the dark, I finally see, and I know.
Maya will wait someday. May the Lord keep us long enough to be there for her wedding. Then we will remind her just before she gets married how she made noise for her mom. Amen? Amen. Amen. Thank you all. May you have your seats. We want to proceed straight away. Mishira have come to exchange their marriage vows and to become one by the plan of God. We are here to assure them of our love for them, and our prayer is that the Lord will smile upon them all the days of their lives. Again, we are gathered here, friends, before God as witnesses to celebrate the blessing of marriage of Jeremy Oscar Onyango and Juliet Njeri, and pray for his blessings upon them now and in the years ahead. Jeremy and Juliet, it is God's intention in marriage that husband and wife commit themselves to each other in love, and in so doing reflect Christ's relationship with this church. In marriage, husband and wife belong to each other, and they commit themselves to each other in absolute fidelity, love, and respect. They are to comfort each other's needs, both emotional and physical. And marriage makes possible the full expression of love between husband and wife. So it is to this manner of life that Jeremy and Juliet have come to be joined today. Our Lord Jesus Christ himself put his seal of approval upon this earthly union by his presence at the marriage in the Cana of Galilee in the Middle East. And you know, while there, he performed the first recorded miracle of turning water into wine. Later on, the Apostle Paul would come and liken marriage to the relationship between Christ and his church as one of perfect unity, tender care, and loving sacrifice, even until death. It is therefore for that reason that marriage must not be entered into lightly, carelessly, or without proper thought, but only after due consideration for the purpose for which it was ordained. Amen?
Amen.
Now, before we proceed, I think it's important we get to celebrate some very important people who this day is their day as well, and that's the parents. I've seen Jeremy's dad. Please, if you can stand up from where you are, let's appreciate him. Thank you, sir, for being here. In fact, come to the front. And then on this side, please, Mr. and Mrs. Mishira, please come to the front. Come and stand beside these children. I know this is your day, so I just want everybody to see you and celebrate you in a proper manner. Can we celebrate the parents? Your children, I met them. Juliet I met, but I'm also the one who officiated Juliet's brother's wedding. Mr. Waidaka is right there with Tabby. So I belong to this family, I know. Did I just make myself a relative by force? And on this side as well. So I met these two. I have walked with them. We have been with them for many months, just looking at what marriage is up until this point. On behalf of the church and the senior leadership at Mamlaka Hill Chapel, we want to wish you the very best. I stand here on behalf of the church leadership, having no doubt that yours will be a great marriage going forward. I have no doubt, and we have no doubt. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. But at this point, allow me to ask, I'm not sure, do we have another microphone? We just want to hear who... We can project. All right. This is a question to you, Mr. and yet Jerry to be married to this man, Jeremy Oscar Onyango. If it's you, say it is us, and yes, we do.
It is us.
Amen. Amen. Again, Mr. and Mrs. Mishira, your daughter has come today to be united in the holy bond of marriage with Jeremy. Do you affirm before God and these witnesses that you give your consent, and do you promise them the continuing support of your prayers, your encouragement, and your love? If yes, say yes, we do.
Yes, we do.
Amen. Amen. Parents, you may have a sacred ceremony. I am now required to ask if there is anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry, to declare it now or forever hold your peace. All right, I'd like to prolong this. Even for the general agony of the groom. I don't know why he's talking to some other men. But anyway, just before the wedding, he told me that he had some people he suspected they might raise objection. So they were given cards that indicated that the wedding is next week. Next year, because of Corona, the wedding was postponed. All right, anyone? No one. Let's celebrate them. Let's celebrate them. Jeremy and Juliet, the vows that you're about to take are to be made in the name of God, who is judge of all and who knows all the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now. Jeremy, do you have any reason whatsoever why you should not be married to Juliet this morning? Jeremy, that is not allowed. Please come back here. There's no reason. Who are these men that you have consulted with?
Two wise men.
All right. Okay. But that is not allowed. All right. So I'll go ahead and ask you, okay? Do you have any reason why you should not be married this morning? No reason. Juliet, do you have any reason whatsoever why you should not be married to Jeremy this morning? No. Again, we appreciate them. I shall now ask you to join your hands as you prepare to exchange your marriage vows. Join both hands. Jeremy, before you say your vows to Juliet, I want to remind you that the Bible says that God wants a man to take a wife for himself in holiness and in honor. He commands the husband to live considerately with his wife and to love her as Christ loves the church. So as you prepare to enter into this sacred covenant of marriage, I shall ask that you do so in a spirit of dedication to the high purpose of God. So I shall ask you now to face Juliet and pledge to her your sacred vows.
I, Jeremy Oscar Onyango, declare before God and these witnesses assembled here that I, me, Jeremy Oscar Onyango, declare before God in this congregation assembled here that you, Juliet Njeri Mishira, are my beloved wife, to have and to hold, for better for us, for richer for poorer, in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, to love and to cherish, and to honor in the Lord, till we are separated by death, according to God's holy law, and this is my solemn vow. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I, Juliet Njeri Mishira, declare before God and these witnesses assembled here that you, Jeremy Oscar Onyango, are my beloved husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, to love and to cherish, and to honor in the Lord, till we are separated by death, according to God's holy law. And this is my solemn vow. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
When I say so, for today only. After this, I'm going. Okay? Alright, they have made their vows to each other, and now we want to proceed and have them seal their marriage vows with their wedding rings. So, Mr. Martin, you have the rings? I need to see both of them, just to be sure. From where I come from, I am looking at the real things. Testimony that Jeremy stands here broke. And that's a good thing. Pray. God, again, we come before you. You know us as human beings, and you know that we forget a lot. And because of that, Lord, you've occasionally asked us to pick symbols that will become memorials, things that will remind us of how you have dealt with us. So, Father, you who has been so faithful to Jeremy and Juliet, you have no doubt. Every day we wake up alive, breathing your oxygen. It means but one thing, that you care, that you are a faithful God, and that you love us. So forgive us for when we forget that. But, Father, for this couple, I pray that every day they wake up in the morning, that moment during the day when they'll look at these rings on their fingers, Father, I pray that they will be reminded that there is a God who has proved himself, and therefore he can be trusted. Father, I pray that they will look at those rings and remember you, and remember that you are ready to walk with them in the coming weeks, in the coming months, and even in the coming year. So Lord Jesus, be with them. Walk with them. May they see these rings and remember that. May they remember that marriage is possible because of who you are, not because of what any one of us is. And that marriage is possible because of what you can do, not what any one of us can claim to do or even promise to do. So, Father, that's our prayer, and may you walk with this couple and establish them. Again, we ask all these.
Juliet Njeri Mishira, I give you this ring as an outward mark that you are my wife, with all that I am and all that we have, I honor you. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
as an outward mark that you are my husband with all that I am and all that we have. I honor you in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
That immediately you place a ring on your finger, you kind of get an itch, okay? So I went ahead, I'm not a medical doctor, I went ahead and invented a cure. So let's try it. The cure is simply to wave at people like this. Yeah. If symptoms persist, keep doing it today, all right? Keep doing it, all right. All right? All right, Jeremy and Juliet, and now having pledged your love for and loyalty to each other, and having sealed the pledge with the marriage rings, I do, by the authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel in the church of our Lord Jesus Christ and in conformity with the laws of this great land of ours, Kenya, I now bless your union and pronounce that your husband and wife. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Jeremy Oscar Onyango. And what God has joined together, let no man put
asunder.
Yes, no man, no matter, no nothing should put asunder. Amen?
Amen.
All right, Jeremy, you can tell people are now quiet. Even the people with the drums, they're not playing drums because time has come when I shall ask you to now kindly proceed and greet your wife with a greeting that will not disappoint any of these guests that you personally invited. And normally we are not in a hurry, the guests and myself. All right.
With all that I have, I do. kufanya tena nitashika mara ya pili.
Kindly hold your wife's hand, okay? All the time, like all the time you hold her, okay? All right, so please proceed and have your seats, and then make sure your wife is on your left side all the time. Pray that you will live all the days of your life remembering that blessed are all who fear the Lord, who walk in obedience to Him. And as you do that, I pray that you will eat the fruit of your labor. Indeed, may blessings and prosperity be yours, bringing joy. May many people rejoice because they too came into your life. Yes, indeed, may this be the blessing for you, Jeremy, as a man who fears the Lord. May the Lord bless you from heaven, and may you see the prosperity of your marriage together all the days of your life. Indeed, Jeremy and Juliet, may you live to see your children's children, and peace be upon you. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully grant you the riches of His grace. And may you know Him both in the body and soul. And living together in faith and love, may you receive the blessings of eternal life. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. And may the Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you peace both now and in the life everlasting. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. DJ, you can give them their song and pray. Amen.
Dreamed up.